Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio is urging her supporters to support the vice presidential bid of her father, President Duterte. The mayor earlier said she is no longer in the presidential race in 2022. That's as she and her father have agreed only one Duterte should seek a national post in next year's polls.
Nagpapasalamat po ako sa lahat ng kapwa ko Pilipino na nagpapahayag ng kanilang pagtiwala at suporta sa akin. Meron kaming maayos na kasunduan ni Pangulong Duterte sa aming kani-kaniyang karera sa politika. Ibigay po natin sa kanya ang pinakamalakas natin na suporta sa kanyang desisyon na tumakbong Vice President.
Several analysts believe Duterte Carpio's supposed disinterest in the presidential run should be taken with a grain of salt. They recall her father used a similar strategy before he ran and won in 2016.
The Philippines' poll body taking steps to address the threat of COVID-19 and the upcoming filing of certificates of candidacies and the conduct of the 2022 polls. The Commission on Elections has relocated the venue of the October filing of COCs to the Hotel Sofitel in Pasay instead of its usual headquarters in Manila. The change of venue is to ensure the safety of COMELEC staff and candidates. The COMELEC is also seeking more funds to secure additional vote counting machines for the actual election day.
As computed by our finance department, we need at least additional of 8 billion, I guess. That is around roughly 8 billion.
So, Madam Chair, 8 billion, maybe the committee can help the COMELEC. Maliit lang na halaga yon para sa safety ng mga voters para sa mas maayos na eleksyon, kahalaga lang yun ang pay shield, 8 billion.
COMELEC suffered a 15 billion peso budget cut for 2022, making it impossible for the poll body to conduct multi-day elections. It adds extending voting hours will also be difficult without additional budget.
The International Criminal Court's pretrial chamber has given the green light to investigate the Duterte administration's war on drugs. The chamber says that based on available information, the so-called war on drugs campaign cannot be seen as a legitimate law enforcement operation, but rather a widespread and systematic attack against the civilian population. The ICC's probe will also cover killings in Davao from November 2011 to June 30, 2016, when the President Rodrigo Duterte served as both mayor and vice mayor. That's as the chamber cited striking similarities between the war against drugs and the killings that took place in Davao. The chamber added that while the Philippines in 2019 withdrew from the Rome Statute, which created the ICC, the court retains jurisdiction over the alleged crimes that occurred from 2011 up to the withdrawal. The pretrial chamber, composed of three judges, based its decision on almost 400 separate supporting materials submitted by former ICC prosecutor Fatou Bensouda. It also considered submissions from more than 200 representations of alleged drug war victims. The Duterte administration has yet to issue a statement, but it has repeatedly said it will not participate in any ICC probe.
Presidential Chief Legal Advisor Salvador Panelo calls out the Senate after Blue Ribbon Committee Chairman Richard Gordon accused President Rodrigo Duterte of inciting to sedition. Duterte earlier barred government officials from attending the Senate's probe on the allegedly anomalous Farmaly deal. But Panelo believes it's actually the Senate that's guilty of that crime, saying the hearings are restraining the executive branch from addressing the pandemic. But senators are unfazed, vowing to continue the probe despite President Duterte's continued attacks.
Hindi naman pwedeng pigilan ng executive department yung mga hindi government officials. Ang pwede lang pigilan yung mga cabinet officials. Pero si Michael lang, hindi naman kabinete yun. O yung si Ong, at saka ito si Christopher Law, hindi na siya gobyerno.
A former Philippine budget official denies Malacanang influence government's transaction with Farmaly. Overall Deputy Ombudsman Warren Leong, the former director of the procurement service of the budget department, was grilled by lawmakers Wednesday as the House resumed its hearing into government's pandemic spending.
Meron ba malalaking tao from the palace na nag-influence sa inyo na to select Farmaly sa mga mas? Meron po ba?
Wala po, Mr. Chairman.
Meron ba nag-utos sa DBM i-award ang contract na ito sa Farmaly?
Wala po, Mr. Chairman.
Si Senator Bongo ba ang nag-utos nito na i-award sa Parmale?
Hindi po, Mr. Chairman. Wala pong nag-utos.
Yung also insisting the medical equipment bought from Parmale were not overpriced. The chairman of the Commission on Audit did not dispute this.
The observations related more to inventory management than overpricing. So hindi po tama na sabihin ang COA ang nagsabi na may overprice kasi wala pong sinabi yon doon sa report.